Welcome to Dhanu on Fire, right here on Hi TV, your luxury channel. This is season 3, made possible by LICC. Today on the show, I am at Galadari at the California Grill. This fine restaurant serves some brilliant dishes. So I'm here to try it, not alone, with one stylish and a beautiful person. And that's of course Danny. More on the show. Welcome to Dhanu on Fire. I'm at California Grill, one of the most brilliant restaurants with a very steady clientele. And if you come to Galadari, this is everyone's favorite place. And with me, I have this gorgeous man, Danny, and that's the only way I could describe you. I think you're blessed with good genes.
Thank you so much for that.
So you would have seen him on billboards, you would have seen him on Facebook or on Instagram, but never got a chance to know who he is and what is he all about. He did represent Sri Lanka for
Mr. International.
Exactly. And how was that experience? Let's start off with that.
That was very interesting. There were so many experiences at once in such a short period. We didn't get much sleep and we had so many photo shoots going on, so many video shoots at once. It was a once in a lifetime experience.
So let's go back. Now, people may wonder whether you're actually Sri Lankan. You are.
Yes, yeah. My mom is a burger from Kadugannawa.
Kadugannawa.
I'm not sure if that's the
Yeah, that's correct.
So, and my dad is from Galt.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so, and you all moved to?
Germany.
Germany. Yes. And you were born and bred there?
Oh. Yes. Yeah.
Okay. That's and right. So you have always had your roots quite close to Sri Lanka though?
Yes, yeah. We used to travel as frequently as we could.
Okay.
And I always loved Sri Lanka. I always loved coming here because we don't have much family in Germany.
Right.
So this is
homebound.
Yeah, homebound, definitely.
All right. So let's speak about, I think you should have your drink.
Thank you.
I'm also in for a treat. This is not orange. This
looks like mango, to be honest.
It's peach. One shot, try some.
I'm good with this.
All right. So tell me about your fashion career. Did you ever, are you involved in it in Germany?
No, not really. I've never, it never came into my mind to come into the fashion industry in the first place. It was only through Brian Kerkhoven, which you know.
Yeah, that you sort of came into this.
Yes, yeah.
Did you ever think that you were cut off for it?
No, not really. No, never. Like, I was, when I grown up, I was a chubby teen and, I actually got bullied, for my appearance
in
public pools. And it's only when I started, dieting and working out a lot, that's when I became aware of my body and properly ate healthy, and then my mindset became healthy, and that attracted a lot of things to me. And also Brian got an eye on me, and he was like, yeah, you should come to Sri Lanka and try it out. And then I gave it a shot, and I thank God that
Tried applying this in Germany
not yet. Because I like this two different world kind of thing.
Okay, so when you go there, it's just very different. And when you come here, it's very different.
I'm the student there. And
just
family bound and, work hard. And I work hard here as well. but it's a different work ethic, right? It's a different work field as well.
So thank you.
Thank you so much.
So what do you study?
I studied to become a pilot, actually.
Oh, really?
Yes, yeah.
And are you becoming one?
I did my PPL, that's the first license.
Okay.
And so now I'm continuing with that. Just moved to a different city for the bigger.
Super. That's like a full license. Package, I'm telling you. You get the whole thing. Just before we order, I just have a few things to ask. Tell me about your food. Are you a foodie?
Yeah, I love food.
Yeah,
I
he was telling me a funny story. He's like, I just had to put on some 5 kilos right now.
Yeah, because working in this industry, you got to keep a certain line.
Yeah.
And I work for G-Flock, as you know. So, I think this company is unheard of. Yeah. I came in, I was fit, pretty shredded, low fat and ripped. I felt good.
Yeah, this is how I should be.
That's what I thought. That's what I had in my mind. And then I come for the photo shoot, and then like I feel good about myself during the shoot,
and
right?
And did a true Sri Lankan, are you feeling sick?
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly what they said, actually. And yeah, then they were like, yeah, you, Daniel, listen up. You got to bulk up a little bit. They said it very carefully. Yeah. But yeah, I got the got the image of it.
Yeah, and just needs to split up. You know, we like a squeezable element. We Sri Lankans are always shaped as pears.
Yeah.
You know how you'll always see a little bundy there, just permanently fixed. It's a nice asset to have.
True.
You know, not everyone needs to be ripped.
Yeah, that's very true.
So tell me about your food habits, because you are a home and company kind of a guy. So do you all have at least one meal together?
When growing up, we always ate together. When it was possible. In the morning, obviously, it was kind of hectic. But like for lunch and dinner, we always sat together and ate. Yeah.
So who is the best cook at home? Is it your mom, dad? Can you cook?
I can cook as well.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I love cooking. Oh. Like, I love it.
We need to get into a break. When we do come back on the other side, we're going to be speaking more about him and what he does. And for those who would have always stalked him on Instagram or found him interesting, well, here's where the answers are going to come your way from. This is Dhanu on Fire right here on Hi TV, powered by LICC. A big shout out to our friends at Galdari Hotel for hosting us here. Dining at California Grill at the Galadari, and I'm in conversation with Danny De Silva. What's a De Silva? Why is that an EZ?
I'm not quite sure, to be honest. Something Portuguese somewhere.
Okay, so just to give you a brief about the food that you get here, the ambiance is great, and the view of Colombo is what the cellar here is. And nighttime is the right time to make your way here. But we just had to do it in the morning because otherwise you'll not be able to see us due to that problem. So Danny was talking to me about one of the common problems that he has. People have asked him whether, are those his real eyes? They are.
They are, yes. Yeah.
Your parents have colored eyes? Why didn't you just dig into your prawns, which you just took away from me?
So sorry about that.
That's fine. So tell me.
Actually, my grandma is the one that has colored eyes.
Oh, really?
She has
it skips
blue eyes.
Generations.
Yeah, that's what I heard, yeah.
Your kids ain't gonna have them.
I hope they do, though.
But that's what I've been told. It skips generation. It's everything skipped my generation. Like, I'm sure if I have kids, they might look better than me. So
you should have kids. And
thanks, Anna.
You look good. So
see,
they will be ugly.
Kind people. Kind people. All right. So tell me about your search to get into this world of fashion. When you go back to your country, the time where you live most of the time, have they sort of figured out that you're like doing some cool stuff here in Colombo?
Yeah, because everybody's connected through social media, isn't it, these days? So my friends, colleagues, everyone knows about it. And yeah, it was weird in the beginning because I'm just this, you know, guy from
how come they didn't pick you there?
Because modeling is not that big in Germany.
Oh, right? Really?
Yeah, it's not, especially not our area.
Okay.
We are living very remote in the Black Forest, so it's very quiet. And Yeah, that's why I never showed any interest in it in Germany, and probably that's why, right?
Oh, brilliant. All right, so what are we having? Just a little recap. I'm having smoked salmon, and he's having prawns.
Yeah.
Correct? How do you like your prawns?
Amazing. They're so tasty. Want to try some?
No, I'll have it later. While we go into this break, that's where I like, sort of rob the food. In terms of your family, tell me about your mom, your dad. I know that he's a chef, but how are you all at home? Like, what's your normal day like back at home?
It depends if they're working or not. Mm. So my mom, she's from Kadungunave, as I said. She's a burger. And she did Miss Sri Lanka as well back in the day.
I'm not quite
sure when. Yeah. She became first runner-up.
Oh, wow. So pageants are in your life.
Yeah, apparently they are.
Yeah.
So, yeah, she encouraged me to do it. And, yeah, she was full-on support.
I saw them at a concert that after 1 year. I subsequently sat next to him. So random. They were all so disciplined. This was me at the concert. I'm like, oh, come on, let's quickly finish this up. But they were so well-behaved, so seated properly. So you have this very kind way of approaching things.
Thanks.
Is that how you are normally? You've always been a soft-spoken guy?
I try, like, that's how my parents, like, brought me up, and always to be kind to everyone, no matter who.
There's always a thank you, there's always a please, 100%. I've always realized it in our little conversations. Yeah, I've noticed that. Are you into, I know that you are into family time and the whole, what do you all do in terms of going, apart from coming to Sri Lanka, do you all do trips abroad?
Oh yeah, we do. We go to Berlin, which is like 10 hours away.
Yeah, okay.
Go shopping together in different cities. And yeah,
you're always together, which is great.
Yeah, not always, but we try.
The Sri Lankan mentality, you know, we always say, you know, family always comes first.
True, yeah.
That's always there.
Which is very different from German ways, because in Germany, like, you move up when you're 18 as soon as possible.
Yeah.
You just go away, and I lived there since 2 months back.
Yeah.
And yeah, that was very unusual for a German kid. Like,
the fact that you still live there. Yes. They should come here. They're like, you're 30 and you're living in your house still? Yes, you're 40 and you're living in this house still?
Yeah, that's the no-go.
Yeah. But I live there always. Yeah. Permanently, that's my house.
Yeah. Which other parents should I live with?
Now, just speaking about your future plans, like, if you get into your, you know, when you become a pilot, would you be stopping what you're doing here?
I won't stop what I'm doing here, because
this is a relaxation.
Yeah, I love these two worlds, like I said before, and I love coming back to Sri Lanka all the time. And you know, seeing this country gives me a reality check in terms of what I see in Germany, growing up in Germany. Coming here, it's a different world.
We'll speak more, of course. We need to get into a break. Big shout out goes out to Olive Couture for styling, and at the same time, LICC for powering this show. We'll see you after the break. Let's get into some of the mains on this side. It's time for us to eat. It's Done on Fire Season 3, made possible by our friends from LICC. We are dining at California Grill right here at the Galadari Hotel. And would like to tell you that in conversation with me, I have this gorgeous man, Danny De Silva. He had sort of shortened his name because Daniel is a cluttered name. So Daniel is like a unisex name anyway.
True.
Like unisex name.
Yes, that's why Danny's...
Yeah. So we were looking at chubby pictures of Danny back in the days. What was your purpose to lose weight and become all lean?
Just for myself, to feel better. And
nothing else?
Nothing else, yeah. Nothing.
Okay, but then that sort of brought you to you taking part in a pageant.
Yes.
How was it when you won it?
It was amazing, feeling to be on stage. And I was frightened for so many years of my appearance. And then, you know, you get awarded for something.
Thank you.
That you worked so hard for. And then,
yeah,
I was just eager to see where this was going afterwards.
How long did your transformation period take?
It's still going on, to be honest.
Really?
Like, yeah, like I work on my body frequently.
Every day.
Yeah, not every day, but I try to do it every day. Yeah, but my biggest transition I did within my first 6 months of my diet. Yeah, I lost like 20 kilos.
Right.
And yeah, shed it down, got a proper physique. And
that was superb.
Yeah.
So you want to always? It was done for your well-being.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Definitely.
Do you like the very thin you? From the chubby you?
Yes, I liked it a lot because for myself, I had more confidence. When I went to the public pool or somewhere, you know, like taking off your shirt was not an issue anymore.
Yeah.
And yeah, I felt good.
Well, I don't think it was an issue even when you were chubby. But
thank you.
I tell you, I still don't remove my shirt anywhere. Like, are the lights off? Are people blind here? All right, fine, thank you. That's my kind of place.
No, you should.
Please, until the jacket's on, I am on the show. When these come out, that's a bit of a problem.
You shouldn't worry about it.
So now that you won the title, when you went for the international pageant, how was it? Like, how was it to represent Sri Lanka? Because you were not brought up here, so it's all about the stories that you would have heard.
Yeah.
How was it for you to sort of narrate the stories? Dig in. Are you a sweet person?
Yes, definitely.
Oh, super.
Huge brilliant. Chocolate tooth.
Ah, there you go. You've got the chocolate. So tell me.
Yes. Well, even though I was not brought up here, I have always had, like, my roots are Sri Lankan.
Mm.
And my heart has always been here. And I took huge pride in it. And I did the best that I could. Then I loved the experience. It was amazing that this country gave me so many opportunities. And my whole life I would try to repay this country for it.
Did people there ask you questions about Sri Lanka and what were your thoughts on it? Like, was it surprising that people knew so much to ask you?
Not really, because growing up in Germany, a lot of people knew Sri Lanka as well as a nice destination to visit, and like this paradise island.
Yeah.
And yeah, it was not surprising, and I loved the questions to, you know, give insight in a lot of things, and also learn some things from some people. I was surprised that some people taught me a lot about their views of Sri Lanka, and yeah, it was like a give and take.
Yeah. Do you keep in touch with the boys, though?
Yes.
Yeah, you do. That's the best part. Yeah, they always end up coming for everyone's weddings. That's what I've seen and heard.
Yeah, I'll definitely invite most of them.
Yeah. Tell me about one of the things that we need to ask. He is single. So
you did have to mention that.
Vacancies, the opportunities are there for applications to come in. So in this industry, we were just speaking about the fact that, you know, it's also an industry where discipline is needed in both ways. You need to be self-disciplined in terms of behaving and representing yourself well. And at the same time, you have to be disciplined enough to maintain yourself. Those are the two things that will take you further. I've always said it. It's two-way discipline.
True.
What would you say is the biggest problem? Because I know it's a hard industry to survive in. Because, you know, everyone is good-looking in their own ways.
True.
And finding your reason is to survive and find yourself with a brand or something to associate yourself with. But where do you think the issue is in this so-called fashion industry? What's the good and what's the bad?
The good is that a lot of people get a chance that don't get a chance anywhere else, and, you know, feel like misfits somewhere else probably because their mind works differently and, you know, the way they are just different and doesn't fit in anywhere else. That's definitely a positive side. It gives you a purpose in a way, but it's also a downside at the same time because people take so much pride in it. They're so arrogant once they achieve something and think they're above everyone else. And that's when, I don't know, that's when I feel like they lost touch with reality. Mm. And yeah, I don't like that side of it at all.
Just to give you a recap of what we have spoken so far, he is a model, but he's going to be a pilot, but he'll always continue modeling. That's his little world here in Sri Lanka. Have you been given movie opportunities? Have you been approached with all of these?
Movies, not so far, but...
Would you act in one?
I would love to, yeah.
Really?
I would love to, but my single is not that good, so...
It doesn't need to be. There's something called dubbing these days.
Right. Yeah.
You can pass on with that. So you are up for all these challenges in life?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
In school, were you an introvert or were you an extrovert?
A little bit of both.
Both?
Yeah, a little bit of both.
What's your favorite sport?
Football.
Football?
Like, yeah, definitely football.
Brilliant.
Growing up in Germany,
yeah,
it was just the only thing.
It's just there always. It's just always. Like how cricket is here.
Always, yeah. Just like cricket here.
Yeah. Yeah. Brilliant. Danny, thank you so very much.
Thank you for
having me. Few things that I have to tell before we close the show. I always make sure that I share a personal experience. Got to know Danny at a show. Then subsequently we met somewhere and then I dropped him home. We had a very long chat. And I got to know how honest and real and down-to-earth he is. I'll give credit to your parents for bringing you up so in a humble way and not to let things hit your head. And
thank you.
When you look like this, it's easy to get caught up in a world that is just full of illusions. But thanks for being who you are, and that's wonderful, and that will take you further. He's definitely a gem of a guy, and my sister said, he's so well behaved, I want to just take him home. I was like, fine. It's always a comparison, quickly. Look at you and look at that boy. Never mind. But definitely a sweet soul, and if you do have time, do get to know him, I think. He has a lot to share. Thank you so very much for being on the show. I'm so happy that I was able to catch you before you fly off.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
And I have you, and have yourself a great 2019.
Thank you, you as well. And thank you for having me. It's lovely being with you. And
brilliant. It's always good to eat with good-looking people.
Yeah, you make me laugh like constantly.
We'll see you with another brilliant episode right here on Dano on Fire. You have yourself a great one. It's a wrap on the show. Mm-hmm.